presentation by Rajesh Yennagure, Assistant Master, GHS Kalburti, Talakochitapur District, Kalburgi. So, what is meant by light? So, you are seeing the prism. This unit contains properties of light, reflection and refraction. What is light? All of you know, light is a form of energy which enables us to see or helps in vision. So, we are seeing laser light. Light travels in a straight line. So, we are seeing the laser light. Light travels in a straight line. Light travels very fast, around 3000 kilometers per second. So, at this speed, it can go around the world 8 times in 1 second. Light travels much faster than sound. For example, thunder and lightning start at the same time, but we will see the lightning first. When a starting pistol is fired, we see the smoke first and then hear the bang. We see things because they reflect light into our eyes. So, you are seeing the student seeing the homework. Shadows. Shadows are place where light is blocked. So, you are seeing the tree shadow. Properties of light and summary. Light travels in straight lines. Light travels much faster than sound. We see things because they reflect light into our eyes. Shadows are formed when light is blocked by an object. So, part 2, reflection. What is meaning reflection? Reflection from a mirror. So, a light incident ray is reflecting back. That is called reflected ray. So, here angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. The law of reflection. Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So, in other words, light gets reflected from a surface at the same angle it hits it. So, second law, incident ray, reflected ray and normal at the point of incident lie on the same plane. So, you are seeing the picture. So, smooth shiny surfaces have clear reflection. Rough dull surfaces have a diffuse reflection. Diffuse reflection is when light is scattered in different directions. So, we are seeing the different directions the scattered light. So, what is meant by refraction? Refraction is when waves bent or slow down due to traveling in a different medium. A medium is something that waves will travel through. When a pen is placed in water, it looks like this. So, you are looking the bent scale or you imagine the pen due to refraction. So, laws of refraction. First law, incident ray, reflected ray and normal lie on the same plane. Second law, Snell's law, that is sin r divided by sin r equal to constant. So, angle of incidence is equal to angle of refraction. Refraction through a prism. White light is passed through a prism, it get diffracted into 7 colors. Phenomenon behind it. Angles I and R that rays make with a normal are the angle of incidence and refraction. Because N2 depends upon the wavelength, the incident white ray separates into its constituent colors upon refraction with the deviations of the red ray the least and the violet ray the most. Color. White light is not a single color. It is made up of mixture of 7 colors of the rainbow. We can demonstrate this by splitting white light with a prism. This is how rainbows are formed. Sunlight is split up by raindrops. The color of the rainbow. So we are looking red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. So adding of colors. White light can be split up to make separate colors. These colors can be added together again. The primary colors of light are red, blue, and green. So you are seeing the primary colors. So adding blue and red makes magenta color, purple. So adding blue and green makes cyan, light blue. Adding red and green makes yellow color. Adding all three makes white again. Lens. A lens is an optical device with a perfect or approximate axial symmetry which transmits and reflects light, converging or diverging the beam. A lens. So you are seeing the lens. Type of lens. Converging or convex lens and diverging or concave lens. So, converging or concave lens. A converging lens is a lens that converges rays of light that are traveling parallel to its principal axis. Converging lenses can be identified by their shape. They are relatively thick across their middle and thin at their upper and lower edges. So you are seeing diverging or concave lens. A diverging lens is a lens that diverges rays of light that are traveling parallel to its principal axis. Diverging lenses can also be identified by their shape. They are relatively thin across their middle and thick at their upper and lower edges. Refraction by a convex lens. Refraction by a convex lens. So you will identify and you should must and should know the rules. Any incident ray traveling parallel to the principal axis of a converging lens will reflect through the lens and travel through the focal point on the opposite side of the lens. An incident ray traveling through the focal point on the way to the lens will reflect through the lens and travel parallel to the principal axis. An incident ray that passes through the center of the lens will in effect continue in the same direction that it had when it entered the lens. So, we are seeing first image object behind 2F. Second image is object at 2F. Ray diagram for object located at 2F. So, ray diagram 3, object between F and 2F. So, you will carefully observe the formation of images. Object at F. So, there is ray diagram for object located at F. An image is not formed.